On the shore of the Bay of Bengal, in the 13th century, King Narasimha Deva of Orissa built at Konark a temple for the sun god. Of the main shrine, only the Jagmohan or assembly hall remains. It gives us an idea of the immensity of the entire structure and the beauty of its concept. This film takes us around the temple exactly as the pilgrims of old performed circumambulation before viewing the enshrined deity, the sun. On India's east coast, man waits for the rising sun, chanting a prayer that has remained unchanged since Vedic times. It is in praise of the sun god, source of the energy that creates life and bestows life equally to all beings. As night dissolves in the light of day, the trek of pilgrims begins. They make their way on foot and on bullock cart to the mighty temple of Konark, which embodies the sun's radiance. They rest only to prepare themselves for the entry into the shrine. Above the main door were once these nine planets. They blessed the pilgrim and ensured a long life to the temple. Benign and fierce, good and evil, they are the masters of time and space, the molders of destiny. The circumambulation begins. Round they will go, performing an age-old ritual before viewing the enshrined deity, Surya Deva, the sun god. Detached from the main shrine is a square structure known to some as the Nat Mandir, or the hall of dance, drama and music. Carved on the walls of the platform are large numbers of dancing and musical figures, vibrant, rhythmic, joyous. Life is here depicted in all its varied aspects, as myriad as the colors and tones of the sun's radiation. It is the sculptor's rendering of the abundant and vital creative force of Surya, who resides within the walls of the temple. Thank you. Leaving the Nut Mandir, we face what remains of the main temple in the form of a gigantic chariot. The chariot symbolizes the solar cycle over a year. The 12 pairs of wheels are the 12 months, one wheel for the dark and the other for the bright half of each lunar month. The seven horses are the seven rays of the sun, modeled with an assured mastery. The celestial chariot seems ready for flight with its seven horses and 12 wheels, driven by Aruna, the sun's charioteer. Suryadeva blazes his way through the heavens. The wheels of the chariot are not just beautifully carved, but infused with a deep significance. Each lotus-centered wheel, with its eight major and eight minor spokes, represents the revolving sun wheel, encompassing time and space. From the hub to the center rim, the wheels are covered with carvings of human figures and animals, of trees and flowers and foliage, all an integral part of the textural pattern which fills the entire temple. Whichever direction the eyes turn, there is a remarkable continuation of the same theme, executed with the same exquisite sensitivity. The life of long ago, transfixed for posterity by the chisels of hundreds of sculptors, stone carved with a passion seldom known. Of Konark are incarnated in numerous forms. The earthly ones are led by elephants. On this panel, even in miniature, they breathe life, romping about, trumpeting their delight, their trunks poised in the air. In life size, however, the elephants have an immortal grandeur, for they were once the guardians of the Northern Gate. By their grooms and trampling upon fallen foes, for they were once the guardians of the Southern Gate. A little bigger than life size, these animals are seen in spirited postures. Looking up at the Temple of the Sun, often described as the Black Pagoda, we are humbled by its colossal scale. Konark represents the great culmination of temple architecture in Orissa. The roof, tier upon tier, rises pyramid-like against the sky, to a lotus-crowned pinnacle, the massive pure stone, the Amalak. On the first and second of these cornices, we behold the Sura Sundaris, the heavenly beauties, boldly conceived, standing out against the blue sky. Above the three doorways of the main temple are the Shiva Bhairavas, dancing in boats. Shiva manifest as the terrible destroyer. On the third and fourth cornices, the lions and the gigantic male human figures. They symbolically, if not structurally, support the circular ribbed finial. There are three shrines buttressed on the temple. The southern shrine with an image of the sun. High boots cover his legs. He wears a cloth of delicately figured muslin. His earrings, necklace, sacred thread and girdle are all beautifully wrought. No detail of the composition escapes the master sculptors of the 13th century. Thank you. the Western shrine. The image here is much the same iconographically. But there is one difference, the headdress. It is an intricately wrought crown. The shrine on the north. Here, the image of the sun is not seen on a chariot, but riding a galloping sun horse. We now stand before the main temple door. It reminds us of everything we have seen and experienced. It explains to us once again the meaning and significance of entry into the temple, that life is a veil, behind or within which is God, that the temple is an image of this life. The carvings and reliefs are profuse, throbbing as it were with the boundless creative energy of the sun. Of the darshana, the viewing of the enshrined deity has arrived. The pilgrim enters the garbhagriha, the sanctum sanctorum. Today, there is only this broken pedestal under the open sky, the god missing and no one knows where. Yet for the devotee, he is here, always for eternity. Surya Deva, pervading the air, the earth and heaven, the soul of all that moves or stands. We retrace our steps, take leave of the temple of Konarak. Living men have touched, as it were, the bodies of the gods, paid homage to the maker of the day.